to all the students of 11th standard. So today we will be starting our English subject chapter 1 from the book Hornbill, and the chapter name is The Portrait of a Lady. Portrait means describing some characteristics of a person. In this chapter it's already describing the characteristics of a lady in this chapter. The main two characters are the author and the grandmother. The main characters are the author and the grandmother. The author Kushwant Singh, he himself is there, and his grandmother. Firstly, let us come to discuss the main characteristics of the grandmother. According to the chapter, the grandmother is an old lady. She is an old woman. On her face, she has crisscross wrinkles. Wrinkles means the skin which is folded. Silver locks. Locks in the sense latte, jo uski baalon ki jo latte hain. That's silver locks, and it's in silver color. Stoop in her back. There is a kind of stoop on her back. And to maintain her balance, she is keeping one hand at the backside to maintain the balance while she's walking. She always wears spotless white clothes. Spotlessness, which is not having any kind of spots or any kind of dirtiness or any kind of bad temptations. She always told her beads of rosary, that means mala japana. And her lips always moved in silent prayers, that means her prayers method was in a very silent manner, not to disturb anyone. And she was so immersed in the prayers that she was a good person. Though she was old, still she looked very pretty. Pretty in the sense, if today she is looking so pretty, that means in her young age, how pretty she might be, how beautiful she might be, and how cute she might be at her young age. So this was the small sketch of the old woman. Now let's come to the sketch of grandfather. Though he is not in the story, but only his portrait is hung on the wall. He is too old to look as if he is having many grandchildren. But in this chapter, reality, he is just looking as if he has a wife and few children. As we come to the author, he is living with his grandmother in the village. But later on, he is shifted to the city and he lives with his parents and grandmother in the city. The grandmother and the author, they have a very good bonding. They have a very good cooperation and mutual understanding in the village and in the city also. How that happens, let us come to understand. The grandmother, she helped the author to get him ready for the school, drop him to the school, make him to understand the Hindi rituals, the customs and the traditions, which were also taught by the priest in the nearby village. But she also used to teach him. She used to guide him, and both always went together and came together. While the grandmother always went with the author, she carried with her some of the stale chapatis for the dogs, for the birds and for the other animals. Stale means basi. So she used to carry with them so as to feed to the animals, to the birds and the other animals. So later, after a few days, they shifted to the city with their parents. And as they were about to shift with their parents, now the grandmother was totally disturbed. Now she was disturbed because the author could not learn the rituals, the traditions, the conditions, and how did he come to know that what are our Hinduism, religions and other things. So she was quite worried, and she did not have any other option. It was the only the option was that she would go with the author to the city. After some days, they shifted to the city. And there, he learned all arithmetic problems. He learned the English lessons. And he learned many other authors' life and other things. But besides these things, he also learned the music and other things. But the only thing was not taught to him was the Hinduism, religions, customs and other epic stories is like Ramayana and Mahabharata and other things. So these things were not taught to him. So for grandmother, it was totally a disturbing thing, because Kushwant Singh, the author, he was totally busy and he couldn't give time to his grandmother. Then after some days, when the schooling was over of Kushwant Singh, now he had to go to the university for his further education. And there he had his higher studies. So besides all this, the grandmother, she was annoyed and she didn't like the way the author was being taught. So slowly what happened? The combination, the bonding and the mutual understanding. So these all were totally disturbed, because author was busy with his studies and grandmother, she was busy with her beads, rosary and prayers and everything. When he returned back, after his university lessons, the grandmother was upset and she wanted to talk many things, but she couldn't describe her emotions and she couldn't describe her feelings and other things. After the university, the author had to go out. He had to go out for his further studies, means out of the city. When he was about to go out of the city, again, grandmother went to see of him at the railway station. She went to the railway station to see him off. But she didn't talk anything. She didn't speak anything. She didn't talk. She didn't say anything that how to live up your life. But what she did, she only kissed on his forehead, and blessed him. In this kind of sentence, here there is no emotion, because she was totally disturbed. She did not show any emotion. So further the days passed. And like this, the few months passed, but the grandmother, she didn't leave her prayers, she didn't leave her feeding the sparrows, she didn't leave feeding the birds or dogs or other animals. So this kind of habit was continued in her. There was a continuation of her daily routine. So we can call it as her daily routine, because she used to feed the animals and other things. When she was left alone in the house, she only prayed. She called the neighborhood women to sing with her, to beat the drums. So like this, she continued her time and she spent and utilized her time. We can call it as utilization of time. That means without the author, she did not think that I am alone or there is no one for me. But instead, she utilized the time by feeding the animals, by birds and other things. Mainly in this chapter, she is feeding the sparrows. The grandmother and the sparrows, they had a good bonding. And daily, the grandmother, she used to do this habit, feeding them, and the sparrows used to come around her. They used to make a circle around her and she used to talk to them. Normally, we know that animals and birds, they don't talk. But when you have a kind of combination and when you love the birds and other things, then you come to know that they are also talking to you. So slowly as the days passed, one day, the grandmother, she didn't get up. And she was feeling some sickness. One day she didn't get up and she was feeling sickness. Sickness in the sense she was very ill and she was suffering from mild fever. So these three things show that she had an illusion that I am going to die and it's my last day to live. So that was the kind of her illusion. So that came in her mind that I am going to die. But before her death, she couldn't talk to the author. She couldn't meet him. She couldn't meet him also. But her prayers, her beads of rosary and other things was continued. Her last day was very emotional and very devotional to the birds. We can call it devotional to the birds. Because that day also she had thrown the breadcrumbs. She used to throw breadcrumbs to the sparrows. Breadcrumbs means bread ke tukde, chote chote tukde, pieces you can tell, breadcrumbs. So like this she used to feed. But the day when she was sick, the day when she was ill, and the day when she had a mild fever, the sparrows, they did not eat the breadcrumbs because the old lady was very sick. At the time of her death, when everyone was ready, everyone was ready for the cremation process. As a person dies, there is a cremation process. When the person, family members, they were ready for the cremation process, the sparrows did not eat anything. They didn't eat anything because they came to know that something has happened wrong here. They didn't eat anything. And they sat very silently near to the funeral of the old lady, near to the funeral of the old lady. They did not move, they did not eat, and they were the full environment, you can call it. The full environment was very silent. Environment was silent. The next day, when she was died, when she died, the sparrows who used to come daily, who used to have the breadcrumbs daily, they did not eat that day. And after the death of the grandmother, the sparrows flew away. The sparrows flew away. Because as the grandmother died, they also flew away. That shows that there was a good human relation, or you can call it as human love, between the birds, sparrows and the grandmother. So when she died, the birds also flew away and they did not come back. The next day, what the sweeper did? The next day, the sweeper, she swept everything. She swept every breadcrumbs which was fallen on the floor. She swept the breadcrumbs and threw it in the dustbin. This shows that the sweeper wasn't that much care that who has died and why the person has died and what was the relation between the bird, sparrows or the grandmother. So human beings are less bothered, but animals, they come to know very soon that something has happened wrong, and now if the grandmother is not there, then sparrows also were not there. In the whole summary, we can come to know that Khushwant Singh says that these two, one human and one living being, they had a good bonding, they had a good relation, and love for them. So summarization is that, though we are human beings, even we should have this kind of bonding love among humans. But it's not there. In this chapter, grandmother, though she loved the author, but she couldn't express her emotions, express her way of speech, or express what she wanted actually. Because slowly, slowly, when she came to know that the author is unable to learn the rituals, the conditions, the Hinduism epics, and about God, about music, then she was very upset. But later on, when she understood that the author has to go in this way only, then there is no other go. But the grandmother did not leave her routine. She always feeded the animals, the dogs, the sparrows and other things. And at last when she dies, the birds were only there near her funeral. And when they were about to take the grandmother for the cremation, the birds also flew away. And the next day, everything was as silent.